ground reality, our top focus will continue to be what has really transpired in Mumbai. In fact, a mundane Monday afternoon has turned deadly after a sudden spell of storm and rain caused a billboard to collapse in a fuel station, killing 14 and injuring close to 44, while 31 people have been discharged from the hospital. Visuals show the structure crashing down right in the middle of the refueling facility, trapping many underneath the debris. Maharashtra Chief Minister Eknath Shinde has called for a high-level probe into the legality of such a big billboard. Now, the Maharashtra government has also announced ex gratia of 5 lakh to the kin of those who lost their lives in the horrible tragedy. Rescue operations remain underway. And in a big development, the additional commissioner of PMC, Ashwini Joshi, has passed an order to remove the rest of the hoardings under the Disaster Management Act.
After receiving a call from BMC, we reach here and start our rescue operation. In that, total 88 persons we have recovered, in which 14 were declared dead by doctors and 31 are discharged by the hospital. Near about 2 a.m. in the morning, with the help of this hydraulic crane, we searched total 3 girders, and in the 4 wheelers we found 9 people, and after giving to the doctor declared them as a death. Problem with the situation is that we are not able to use our gasoline based cutting equipment, as it is a petrol pump. And we are total 2 teams here, 28 and 25. Thank you.
Shrishti, my colleague who has been reporting from Ground Zero continuously for us, joins me live. Shrishti, as far as we speak about this particular incident, it is horrible to say the least, but the implications of the same in terms of rescue operations, what is it that you can tell us for the moment?
Well, of course, we are reporting from Ground Zero. What I would like to tell you is that we are standing in front of the one leg of this particular hoarding, which collapsed on the petrol pump. And you can see in the visuals, as we spoke to the expert, he told us that the depth of the particular leg of this hoarding should have been more than 7 to 8 meters. However, it is not even 3 meters. There are certain lapses while constructing this particular hoarding. Remember, BMC says that this was unauthorized and BMC did not give any kind of permission for this hoarding to be put over here. Now, what comes across is that there should be holes as well inside the hoarding so that the wind can pass, and there should be a balance maintained in the air while this particular billboard is so huge and a huge metallic structure has been put up over here. Also, BMC has said that it gives permission for the hoardings to a certain extent of, lengths and breadths, but this was 120 feet of massive metallic structure which was being put up, and that permission was not given by BMC, and that was given by the Railways Department in Mumbai. That has also been transpired. Now you can see the other billboard also in on the other side of this particular petrol pump. There are certain lapses in the construction of that billboard also. That's what the experts, the disaster management officials have told us. But you can see the disaster, you can see what aftermath is there here in the visuals. There are several vehicles which are in debris at this particular place. 14 people have died. Several are still critical. What BMC is saying is that there should be a proper audit, and they have ordered for it. However, what was done to check this particular site, that still needs to be, answered by the BMC. However, Chief Minister Eknath Shinde has said that the audits will be done for this hoarding as well as the hoardings which are put up by BMC as well as other departments across the city, and proper investigation will be done. 5 lakh rupees has been also announced by the Chief Minister to the people who have died. But why such situation comes up, that is the basic question that we are also asking. However, yesterday it was just raining for half an hour and it was a windstorm, and this is the situation in the city of Mumbai, wherein you can see now several vehicles are smashed below this particular hoarding, and 14 people have died, and several are still in critical condition. one cannot even imagine the gravity of the particular incident, wherein you can see this billboard is almost like a half a football ground, and it has came down like anything on this particular petrol pump. People didn't even get a minute of time to run around, and that's what claimed their lives. And now still there are 30 to 35 people who are in hospital battling their lives there, and authorities are trying to check and investigate the particular matter. However, the checks and balances that needs to be done on the prior basis, that was not done, is what we can tell.
Shruti, as you point that out, in fact, you are telling us the background of this, more importantly, showing us what the debris over there is looking like in terms of the ramifications of this horrible incident. But here's something we should put into context, right? We see multiple such instances, considering the fact that it could be also because of lapses that come into the matter. An FIR, of course, has been, filed, yeah, but there's no accountability that has been taken yet. We understand there's a tussle there as well.
Well, of course, yesterday BMC has given out one document wherein they have said that there is no permission, there is no NOC taken by them for putting up this hoarding. However, Central Railways has said that there is no relation of railways to this particular hoarding. Now, who is at the receiving end? The commoners, the people who lost their life. And why the accountability is not said, that is the main question. However, Railways has not given out any statement as of now. Chief Minister has said that a high-level investigation will be done. But why such incidences unfolds when it rains just for half an hour in the city of Mumbai? That is really a big question. And this is not for the first time, and this is not the first place. It has happened in other areas of Mumbai wherein a tree fell and a person has died, and some other incidences as well. But this is horrific. Horrific visuals we can show you here from
Absolutely.
The ground zero. You can see this entire hoarding just Shruti, came
as you down
pointed
out,
within
I have
seconds.
To interject
and
you, but you're absolutely right. Horrific visuals, no accountability. We've seen multiple such instances, but I appreciate you joining us from ground zero to tell us the implications of this incident that's had. In fact, we're just going to be focusing on those visuals for a second from the accident site. But let's leave the conversation at that, because we're shifting our focus.
After receiving a call from BMC, we reach here and start our rescue operation. In that, total 88 persons we have recovered, in which 14 were declared dead by doctors, and 31 are discharged by the hospital. Near about 2 a.m. in the morning, with the help of this hydraulic crane, we searched total 3 girders, and in the 4 wheelers, we found 9 people, and after giving to the doctor declared them as a death. Problem with the situation is that we are not able to use our gasoline based cutting equipment, as it is a petrol pump, and we are total 2 teams here, 28 and 25. Thank you.